back on the camera. High boy, just consider me flammable. Sure shot, I got all the intangibles. Need a leash, I'm a beast, I'm an animal. Heat the competition up like a Hannibal. Know the game like I wrote up the manual. What you do on the annual? MVP, that decision unanimous. Big dogs, I don't think they can handle it. Battlefield, it's just me and my warriors. Guaranteed, we emerging victorious. Years blessed, wet tears, it's glorious. I remember when they all was ignoring us.
Dash, dash,
cut it on, smash,
smash.
Foot on the gas, I will not crash. They will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone, watch me. Celebrate, I'm cocky. I do my dance, jump in the stands. No man, the man, Odell with the hands. Thought he could guard me, I ruin they plans. I do what I want, they do what they can. Got it on, smash, put on the gas. I will not crash, honey y'all dash. Honey y'all dash, honey y'all dash. Honey y'all dash, honey y'all dash. They slept on the team that they owe me. I need a ring and a trophy. I say I'm the best cause I am. It's noted in keeping it low-key. I can carve up the D like a turkey. I run straight through the D like a train. This year we ain't taking no losses. It's all about making the game. I hear a lot of trash talk. He call himself making a name. I put on a jet. The coach will regret it, but letting him stay in the game. See, my route took a tumble. Next time, be humble. I'm the lion in the jungle. You just try not to fumble. Rumble, young man, rumble. Never slip nor stumble. I take off, poof, magic. Now watch me juice through the chest. Footwork fantastic. Dominating the plastic. Treat the pocket like plastic.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen,
are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
Thanks, Coach. Just north of the Delaware Expressway and east of Broad Street, we find ourselves at Lincoln Financial Field in South Philly. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Washington Redskins. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And they'll have excellent field position to begin this drive as he's all the way up to midfield at the 50.
Well, that return gives him a golden opportunity to go out in front. How will the defense respond after giving up that type of a return?
Let's go now. 60 Pittsburgh.
Now 2 years in the making, Darius Geis' first NFL carry. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. Now this matchup, an important one for week one, an NFC East bout right off the bat. These two teams have met twice a year since 1936. 168 meetings overall, and the Redskins lead the series, but the Eagles, they have won four straight against these Washington Redskins. Now this one complete on the slant route. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They run with Adrian Peterson, the second active leading rusher in the NFL. It was Josh Sweat who got him down on the defensive side.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five.
Oh, you got deep? Hey, watch it, watch it.
Smith hands off to Geis. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. From the gun on third down, Smith. And he's got his man on the out route. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 18.
Well, he's looking sharp right from the get-go here. Tough division. They needed this kind of a start. But I think this is part of where scripting comes in. We always hear about the scripting of plays, how they're going to be called. Everyone dress rehearses their script, and right now they're following it to a T.
And for that opening drive, so part of the script still to come, right, partner?
Yeah, no doubt about it. We've got a ways to go with that, but you can tell that they worked on the script the entire week in practice, and it's paying off for them.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and five at the 13-yard line.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Alert.
Now a run with Geis. And he's going to get about four down inside the 10 to the 9.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
It's been a seven-play opening drive, and this is third and short. They'll try and get it with Geis, and he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. They only got two, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it first and goal.
Down. 10 Tucson.
59.
General West and Alpha.
Tighten up.
They'll try the air now with Smith. Rodgers brings it in. 3 yards is the gain that time. Second and goal.
And partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Geis alone in the backfield here. Second and goal. He'll get it up the middle, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Redskins. Taking it in from 4 yards out as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Excellent start there. First drive of the season, big-time success, putting it in the end zone.
And remember, that was done without any real map of how to do it. In other words, the deeper you get into the season, you get game film to work off of, tendencies to work off of. The first drive of the season, things can be entirely different than what you've seen in the past. It's a really good job of execution by them.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Flush to his right. Now he'll pull it down. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line. 2nd and a yard.
51 to Mike. Let's go, D.
2nd and 1. It's caught by Jackson. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 2 yards, good enough for a first. That catch now puts him on the doorstep of 500. It's his 499th reception. So first and 10 now from the 30. He'll drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Kevin Pierre-Louis coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now the first career carry for the Penn State star, Miles Sanders. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. One that's intercepted. Reuben Foster picks it. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. When the rookie QB gets his first touchdown pass, that's one you put in the trophy case. First career interception, that's going to be one he wants to forget.
Yeah, and he's not going to go ask for the football. Right? Yeah, you can keep that one. The key for him, what does he learn from it? When he watches the tape, does he have an answer right now where he already understands what mistake he made? That's what the coaches are going to want to know, and that's what they'll grill him on and see how he grows from it.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Here's Smith. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
Got it.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, here's Smith. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And they're not going to get the snap off. This might back him out of field goal range. So on fourth down, the Redskins will call on Tress Way to punt it away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They had the auspicious beginning to the season, a first drive turnover. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels, where they can hit you with it. Sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
They go play action here on first down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10.
Watch twins.
Second and 10. And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. It's a gain of 16 and an Eagle first down.
It's a gain of 16 yards. That's good for an Eagles first down. First and 10 at the 50-yard line.
Check 52. Check, watch it, watch it.
First and 10, it's Sanders. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and 11. It's a second down run with Sanders. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Washington territory. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a third and 8.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
And the Redskins have an extra man in the secondary here on third. Back to throw. Man open, it's Goodwin. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th. Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Yeah, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Throwing is Smith, rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go. And got his man complete. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, his first NFL reception, goes for 6. And the Redskins get the quick strike touchdown. Extra point good by Hopkins. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Already ready at the line. This Philly offense set to go. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on first and 10. A pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about six. It's a six-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. Second and four. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 4 yards the pickup, first down. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand.
Scouting for when we see guys like that make that type of a catch, not fair goes through my brain. That size, that speed, and now they're acting like wide receivers,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, tight end one-handed catches. They're kind of like wide receiver one-handed catches nowadays.
Just not right.
He'll look to throw. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
They'll look to throw. A bullet throw, but incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Smith now to throw. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Open man, the tight end Rodgers. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Ready.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now a toss. This is Geis. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Jalen Mills in on the stop.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory. Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half.
Check, check.
No. Hey, Wahoo!
Get it.
From the gun on third down, Smith. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. The Redskins now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play.
60 outlaw.
I'm going to run you over. I'm going to run you over.
Go.
Hey,
Zoo.
First down, here's a run with Peterson. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. This defense could use a few more plays like that right now.
It certainly could, but think about it from an offense's perspective right now. They've got a lead, but they don't want to throttle down too much and stall.
Oh, it's out. Smith lost it. And it's picked up by the Eagles. But they will not be able to capitalize as time has run out here on the first half of play. So we are at halftime here in the opener of the 2019 regular season. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, we'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Let's field it at the two. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Second and 11. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down.
Credit the secondary and credit the defensive game plan. They've been in his hip pocket all game long. They understood coming in that he was a big-time receiver.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw. And that's going to be intercepted. Landon Collins, the Pro Bowl safety. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said, third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now. At the 47-yard line.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
Yo, 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 go, go. Hey, Delta.
53, Mike.
Here's Geis. And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Third and two, Smith. And trying to get it to his tight end, Rodgers, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He'll hit Jackson, complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And he has now hit number 500. Charles, that is his 500th NFL career catch.
Definitely worthy of applause, but I remember when 500 meant you were going to the Hall of Fame. Nowadays, in today's football, 500 puts you on the path, a significant number.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Here's second and eight. Blitz coming and down he goes. Off the edge, the sack by Matt Ioannidis. A rookie QB struggling, gets thrown down to the ground there. But, you know, maybe this game, it's not over yet, but maybe this game can be a learning experience for him.
So many different things that he has to pick up on. When to go ahead and flush from the pocket and run. When to get rid of the football and not take the sack. When to just go ahead and go down early and make sure you don't fumble the football. So many things that he has to learn. This game starts the process.
And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. And the kick by Elliott is good. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. So he splits the uprights and has to be a nice feeling. Right when it left his foot, knew it was good.
Yeah, just like a good three-point shooter in basketball, right? Release the ball, fall back on defense without even looking. You know it's going in the hoop.
Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or do you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. On the ground, it's Geis. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Again, they run. Again, it's Geis. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Ready, break.
Mike is 59. Mike is 59. Hey, defense, let's go.
Bristol, travel.
Smith gonna throw on 3rd and 1. Well, the two men come together and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively, brings up 4th down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
We got to step it up.
Here's a 2nd and 7. He's going to walk one deep left side here. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
Brings up third down and seven.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. They'll drop the throw. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 14. And he will score. Touchdown, Washington. On his Hopkins now for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-6.
Makes the score Redskins 21, Eagles 6.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
I can't believe they even let you play.
After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And that's complete to Sanders. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. They'll set up a throw. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Looking to erase a two-score deficit here in the fourth quarter. Going for some big plays.
Yeah, they certainly were. They just decided one shot, didn't they? Forget trying to move the ball downfield in small little increments. Let's go for the big one. But how about the defense playing situational football, looking at the scoreboard and realizing what can hurt us most? The deep shot. They played it well.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. The Eagles on third down. They're struggling. 0 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10. Pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Here's Cameron Johnston now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And this one will wind up being down just outside of that 20-yard line. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away.
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now a first carry for their fullback. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down.
Let's go.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. Following the penalty, it's Peterson. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
Brent, this is clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there, and now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Mike 59. Let's go, defense.
On 2nd and 11 now. Smith. Looking left side, he's got it, complete. That catch good for 5, it's 3rd down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
The Redskins on 3rd down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be 3rd and 6. To throw a Smith. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. He's strong safety. Some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it. All right? So you got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Right back to Sanders on 1st down. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down.
He's coming.
On 1st and 10, it's Clement. He's got a 1st down and then some inside the 40. And down right around the 37. A big pickup there for the Eagles. 1st down, 18 yards. I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme, when you have a blocker.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Dallas Goedert, 37 yards. As they're now just an extra point away from getting back within 1 score. Elliott good on the extra point as this gets him back within a touchdown and a 2-point conversion. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone.
That return gets all the way to midfield, so we know the field position is absolutely flipped at this point. If I'm the defensive coordinator, I might think about blitzing right now to try and take field position back.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here 1st and 10, right at the 50-yard line.
57, Mike, 57.
From the 50, it's Smith. He's going to let this one go for Latimer. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Cody Latimer, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on 1st down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on 1st down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up 2nd down.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Now this one complete on the slant route. The 20! And they will finally catch him, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Big yardage that time for the Redskins. 42 yards.
Let's get there.
ship.
Geis, they'll try to run it. He fights his way into the end zone for a Redskin touchdown. Darius Geis, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Redskins are able to stretch the lead out further. Hopkins with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Second and 10. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Fabian Moreau, and they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
Ready?
Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves them with 2 to go on second down. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. We'll likely put an end to this thing.
Ready?
Again to Peterson, out of the gun. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to bring up a third down. Now it's Smith. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. And he gets this away, angled for the sideline with a lock behind it. Wow. They've gone final now in Charlotte, and it was the Panthers that wound up winning that one. Christian McCaffrey, he was up over 100 yards rushing. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Flushed out right. He'll get 5 out of the scramble, his second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Second and 5. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll set up to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. That's Thomas Davis on the sack. Came in the league way back in 2005. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. Fake. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Montez Sweat brings him down, and that's a play.